season as the stats bounce up there for us. No turnovers, and that could be a very big factor. The pass, 7 of 10 for LSU, and 3 of 6 from Mississippi State.
Oh, bids start going out, and who knows? It is 24-24, and it is James Wagner to kick off, and it is Glenn Young in his deep. Young in the end zone, about 4 yards, will bring it out. Gets a good block. Look out, Young. Quinn misses him. He's going to go 104 yards for a touchdown. Oh! First play of the first half. Mississippi State scored.
Sometimes you say you should never run it out from behind the goal line. You can see him feeling the ball now about 4 yards deep in the end zone. Makes the catch. Nobody said stay back in there. And here he comes, and watch the blocking. Beautiful block right there. And then his speed as he shook off the last man, picked up another fine block. And when it turned into a foot race, he had more foot.
Second touchdown of the day for Glenn Young. Bob Morgan comes on, adds the extra point. And if you want his running time, it is 12 seconds. That's how long it took him.
A lot of lateral moves here, so I've got to figure he went the 100 yards in under 10 seconds. You can see him right on the hash mark there. He broke it right down the middle of the field, picks up that excellent block, shakes the one man, kind of had a hold of him right there, and then picks up a beautiful block from number 30. A great, great block by Windham to make it easy for him to take it into the end zone.
Ellington is a man deep now, as you see Young go into that end zone as a kickoff is coming from Bob, or rather Dana Moore.
I was going to say, Jim, that after they'd received the kickoff, that they scored on 4 of their 5 possessions in the first half, or 6 rather, when the clock ran out on the last one. And could they score on this possession? They did the first time they touched it.
Moore to kickoff. Only 12 seconds have gone by in the second half. Moore's kick. Whoops. Runs by Lang. He touches it. Better pick it up. Ellington picks it up. Ellington gets across the 10. Lost the football. Belongs to Mississippi State. Picking it up very quickly. Number 44, who is not listed on the roster of Mississippi State.
It's a very poor kick, as you
now
can see.
Now we got it. It is Bo Robertson, a reserve linebacker.
Sculled the ball. The ball hits the ground, bounces around. Everybody's kind of scratching around. They're reaching for it. Nobody can get a handle on it. Ellington finally does pick it up. By that time, they've penetrated way downfield. He's hit hard. He fumbles the football. Mississippi State recovers.
Robertson not only made the hit, but got the football. Straight ahead goes King. Donald Ray King. Well, it is second down. And about
first,
9 to go. Look at this again.
First turnover of the game. The ball takes some crazy bounces here. It hits. Poor kick. Bounces around. Nobody can quite get a handle on it. They kick it a little bit with their foot. Ellington picks it up. His blockers form a little bit, but he gets out in front of the blockers. He's hit as he goes down. He drops the ball. And there is Mississippi State in possession on the 13-yard line.
LSU just seems to play in adversity. They were down 14 to nothing in the first half. Now the handoff is to be good. Lost the football, but out of bounds at the 8-yard line. It'll be 34 to go. Ellis comes wide to the left. 31-24. Only a minute has gone by in the third quarter. Mississippi State close to getting another touchdown. Bonds has the football. Very close to a first down. Remember, he does not have to cross the goal line.
Would like to turn it upfield sharply, but he was not able to do so because the pursuit just sort of swarmed all over him. You can see him cut up the field here. He tried to lower his shoulder, spin, but a very fine defensive play by the entire secondary led by Quinn kept him from falling forward.
First down and goal to go, signals referee Boy Smith. Mississippi State crowd gets quiet so Bond can call. Results and down quickly goes King near the goal line.
Lowe taking the submarine charge.
They only have inches to go. Quarterback sneak or not? Hand off, and that is King, and that is a touchdown.
Mississippi State linemen just simply surge forward.
The kick is good. It is 38 to 24. 2 minutes and 1 second have gone through. The LSU, you've got to try to do it again. Come from way behind. Now the deep man here is Lang. And Lang slips inside the 15-yard line. Down there was Fesmeyer, but Mississippi State. Risher hands the ball off across the 15-yard line, and not much there. As you can see,
it's very difficult to rush the passer. Let's see if they can do that.
Lionel Wallace goes wide to the left. Risher carries the football, pitches back to Jude Hernandez, is knocked out of bounds by number 20, Larry Friday.
And then begin to give up.
Big play here, third down. And about three to go. Risher carrying the football, throws it out to Hernandez, who I think's got the first down. Near the 24-yard line. If he got to the temperatures in the high 50s, it is not frigid by any means, but it has been a red-hot football game, if you'll pardon the pun. Here's Risher rolling out. Here's Risher throwing, and it is off the hands of Lionel Wallace at the 38-yard line. A senior could not hold it. Orlando McDaniel comes wide to the right, and Tracy Porter goes to the left. A couple of speedsters on second down 10. Risher instead pitches the ball back. Here is Monts, and Monts is collapsed as he hits to the 27-yard line. Fesmeyer and Friday, the fumble, and pop it right in the end zone. Wallace wide left, Porter wide right. And Risher back to throw on third down, being chased. Dumps it out and over the head of Hernandez, who'll have to kick the ball away. The line of scrimmage.
Arm up in position to make a good throw.
Marty McDowell back to take the punt of Dave Johnston. He had a tremendous punt return in the first half. Takes the ball at the 27-yard line. Uh-oh, no place to go now. The ball's at the 32. And the Bulldogs take over there. First down and 10. Excellent big man. Over 200 pounds. First down. And he's going to throw. And there's McDowell out in front of everybody. See you later. Touchdown. 68 yards.
Great execution of the play action. LSU had both safeties up, getting ready to support against the running attack. They take the bait for just a couple of strides, but it was a marvelous throw again by Bond. He hit McDowell perfectly in stride. Had he had to slow up at all, he'd have been caught from behind. Marvelous execution.
Well, I want to tell you, as Bob Morgan comes in, everybody expecting perhaps the Bulldog to hang on up by 14. But no, on first down again, they throw for a touchdown. Nearly 69 yards, 68, 69 yards, and they're up by 21. It's 45-24. The Sugar are looking at the sun, but the Bulls are in their picture.
They got kind of stars in their eyes. You won't see any better execution than this. Fine fake of the run. McDowell is behind everybody as Quinn and Williams both get caught up a little bit on that excellent running fake. The pass was right on target, perfectly in stride to McDowell, and nobody's going to catch him as we take one more look at it. There's the basic fake to King. Easy to block a man when you fake with the ball. And the pass, perfectly thrown, and also perfectly caught.
All right, again, Lang is a deep man. Remember, Ellington was the deep man, as you watch McDowell go into the end zone, until there was a mix-up between himself and Lang. He picked it up and fumbled the football. So another freshman, Lang, on the last kickoff, and on this one, is the man in the center, as Dana Moore will kick off against the wind. A Mississippi State fan. Will be pardoned if they figure they got something going.
Yeah, they do.
Lang. Well, he's going to bring it out to the 10 and slides across the 15 to the 16, and the flag goes down. Out of peaking, and a clip was called against LSU. 1 point for Mississippi State. Risher looked as though he wanted to hand the ball off.
But when you're blitzing, of course, you're going to get the penetration and get back in there.
Second down. and 11 to go. And that hardly picks up anything at all.
Passes.
For the first time, we've got two wide receivers to the left. Fisher picked up the football after dropping it, and down he goes with Johnny Cooks on top of it.
Johnny Cooks faked the rush, and I think that call
got the wind at his back. McDowell is back in his own territory at the 47. Johnson with the wind at his back hangs it high. McDowell back at the 44. Trying to get around the corner. Flag goes down as McDowell goes down. Take line. 9:15 to go in the third quarter. It is 45-24. And I'm not laugh credible. Bond, first down. Bond on the handoff and trying to get around the corner and unable to. It's George Wansley, another fine freshman on a touchdown today, the most spectacular of which, 104-yard kickoff return to start the second half. And to start the blitz that Mississippi State is enjoying, Bond turns it up as they get a little conservative with a 21-point advantage.
Made it with your ball control. First down is the critical down. This particular possession, they just haven't done anything on first or second down.
Third down as Danny Knight now starts in motion to the right. Bond drops straight back and throws it out here and has his man. That is Wansley with great speed. Wansley dragged out of bounds, but he has got a first down. Britt took him.
Corwin, you're trying to set up the screen.
Marcus Moore, a freshman, comes in as a linebacker on the near side of the field. Number 95. First down. Mississippi State hands the ball off, and that is King. And King gets into LSU territory. Well, I tell you, they run the ball for 3 or 4 yards. Mississippi State, the team, does not know how Georgia's making out this afternoon with Auburn. They can only hope that Auburn beats Georgia and they can go ahead and win the Southeastern Conference. Wansley carries the ball to the 45-yard line where he is stopped there. And you can see that the Young again, wide left. Bond hands off to King again, and King is very close to the first down. All depends on where they spot the football inside the 45-yard line. LSU covered up. You can see the
and up by 21.
I can tell you a bunch of reasons why not, Jim, but they're going to go for it anyway.
Yeah, I think John Bond will take it again. Looked like they may have moved. I think they moved, and instead of a first down with King carrying the football, I think it's...
You hate to give up 40 yards of field position. The movement, I think, was by McDowell. He was just a little bit too anxious. It was either Price or McDowell who moved. Take a look there at the left of the screen. No, it was Price who moved, the tight end, and he just moved a little bit ahead of the ball, and that brought up the penalty, which now forces Mississippi State to punt the football.
Dana Moore to kick it away to Chris Williams. Rushes on. He is knocked down, but no flag. Williams, an outstanding punt returner, does not have much of a chance. Knocked down at the 23-yard line.
A rather stiff wind coming from the left of your screen.
Porter to the left, McDaniel to the right, and Risher back to throw. They need points in a hurry. Throws the ball out here, and Dijon is bumped into by Vesmeyer, and Vesmeyer wants offensive passes.
It is procedure.
And they refuse it. Johnny Cook. And Porter is going to the left. And Risher on a quick handoff. And up top is Johnny Cooks. There's some folks down at the bottom there. Down an eight. Risher in a pass situation and a must get a first down situation. Risher throws, coming out of the backfield. Guy John can't hold on to it. Fourth down, they got to kick it away. David Johnson to kick it away, and Mississippi State's going to get the football again. As long as they got the football, LSU can't score. That's obvious. But another thing, they can run down the clock. Here's McDowell. Fine play, but he spins away and is down at the 29-yard line. Looked like he might have been gotten. We've seen Mississippi State against Miami. We did not see them against Alabama when they won that ball game. But I'd have to say that the Bulldogs are for real.
They really have been strongly that way with a little bit of a suspect defense in the first half, but their offense, marvelous.
First down, defense is what won the ball game for them against Alabama. Bond pitching back. Here comes Haddix around the corner. Haddix steps out of bounds. but not until he picks up a first down near midfield. And now they seem to be running at will against LSU. Addicks, a sophomore out of Walnut, Mississippi.
That's just kind of classic execution of the basic play and the Mississippi State attack, which is the triple option off the wishbone. Here comes the first fake. And you'll see King go for the ball. Bond reads it. Then Bond pitches the ball out to Haddocks. They've got the corner man blocked downfield by McDowell, the wide receiver. And if the field had been a little bit wider, he'd have gone a little bit further.
Bond hands the ball off. Straight ahead goes Donald Ray King. Off return is the longest in school history. The other one was 99 yards back in 1936.
You don't run very many of them out of the end zone.
Here's that double reverse again. Flag is down in the middle of the field as McDowell goes out of bounds, shy of the first down. The flag went right down in the middle of the field as this play developed. And there's a holding charge, and we'll see. I don't know if we can see the holding, but we can see the play.
Well, let's take a look and watch this very good ball handling. Bond giving the ball to Haddocks. Very quick exchange. Haddocks giving it to McDowell, and you can see how the defensive people were moving in the wrong direction there. It appeared that he had something, but the support of the defensive secondary was excellent and picked up short yardage on the play in addition to getting the holding penalty.
And look who was out in front blocking for him, John Bond. It is not unusual. 3-2 to go. Ball back on the 37-yard line of Mississippi State. Knight in motion to the right. Bond. He's not afraid to put it up. He puts it up to Haddocks, and Quinn drags him down, and a flag goes down. He may have by a face mask. Haddocks thinks so, and that's what it is.
Pass. Bond is rolling out here. He sees Haddocks is open. He dumps the ball off to him. Quinn comes up, and yes, he does have that face mask, and it's a blatant face mask penalty. Sometimes it's inadvertent, but that time he had his hand on it and maintained his hand on it.
It is second down after having 21 or 22 yards to go and only a yard to go. Ball now on the 42-yard line of LSU. 3:30 to go, third quarter, 45-24, Mississippi State. McDowell in motion this way. Bond carries a football. Bond keeps the football. Bond's got the first down. Inside the 40-yard.
Short future is going to, I believe, have some challenges to Alabama's dominance.
And Georgia this year. Straight ahead. Bond hands the ball to King. And King picks up good yardage inside the 35-yard line. Down to about the 30. As it is, they're trying to wind up 8-2 and with a bowl bid in pocket by the end of the evening. McDowell in motion to the right on second down. And that is Haddocks carrying the football. Williams catching it from behind. First down inside the 20. Chris Williams, a saving tackle.
Really dominant all afternoon. This is just a quick handoff. There's the fake. The fullback really didn't fake for it. He just moved through the line. Matt Edwards comes across and makes the key trap block to break Haddocks into the open. Haddocks is a fine runner, but that's just beautiful line blocking and great team execution.
Wallace wide to the, I should say, Young wide to the right. Hand off. It is Bond keeping the ball. Everybody, including me, thought he'd handed it off, but he doesn't. He's inside the five. It's first and goal to go. And a Mississippi State man is down, but helped by Mississippi State should they go on to win by what happens in other ballparks. But they know they're going somewhere and should know in a couple of hours. First and goal to go. First man through is King. Touchdown. And as I say, I think that just... And they've almost... Well, they have. They've more than doubled the score with this touchdown of LSU.
Beautiful execution again. Bond puts that ball in so softly. When you're a quarterback, you don't want to ever slap the ball at the stomach. That causes a rebound and can be a fumble. He just nestles that ball in.
Oregon, they kick the extra point. And can you believe that 28 points State in less than a single quarter? And he has been asking the crowd, let's go. There he goes again. He's getting him up on the feet. A sophomore out of Athens, Georgia, trying to get the crowd pumped up and his own team pumped up. Moore kicks off against the wind. Bradshaw watches it go into the end zone, out of the end zone, will come out to the 20-yard line. First, LSU very much in the running for a bowl before this game, might still get one. Fisher hands the ball off. But I tell you, the way they are getting trounced here in the second half does not help their chances.
I think you can see the defensive play that time of Keys and Barnes, where they're just controlling the men in front of them instead of trying to penetrate. That enables you to move laterally to the ball, and you don't get burned on those quick handoffs.
Look at that score and scoreboard. Hernandez, the last ball carry, of course. Risher not putting the ball in the air on the first play. Now will put it in on second down. Look out, he is in deep trouble. First man to hit him was Tyrone Keys.
A little bit, the margins become very large.
8 seconds to go. Question whether or not they get another playoff. 5, 4, 3, 2. We're in the third quarter. 1. They're not going to get it off. That's the end of the third quarter. And what a third quarter. It might be the most important third quarter in recent Mississippi State University history, and I include the Alabama game. With Bowl Scouts here, invitations in hand, they scored 28 points to go. From the 12-yard line, Richard back to throws. We start the fourth quarter, puts the ball up in the air, could be intercepted. It is intercepted by Friday. Friday's across the 30. Friday is down as he hits to the 22-yard line. And if there's any doubt, there it is. First down, he leads the state team. A transfer out of Alcorn State.
Straight drop back pass. He's set. He gets a little bit of pressure, but not enough to bother him. The pass is underthrown. There, two or three men could have picked it off. Friday does make the interception. He picks up the blocking of his linebackers, and they've got great field position.
Harrington is in at quarterback. He's got the football. Why keep Bond in there when they're up by this much and they need some experience? That is Woodham, or Witt, as they say. And now we have a new man, and that is Schaffhauser, formerly quarterback, who is wide left as a wide receiver, number 15. And the first man through is Henry Kuntz, who came in to carry the football. Number 33, a fullback.
John Bond is, as I said at the start of the game, perhaps the best freshman football player in America, and what a career he has ahead.
Oh, he is a freshman. Harrison with the football, and LSU's got Harrison. And it'll be fourth. We have never had a more exciting first half this year, 24-all. We've never had a more explosive third quarter or any quarter this year than the 28 points of Mississippi State. They may have taken too much time, and if they did, snap is perfect, and the kick is good. It is 55-24. Sometime during the holiday season, you will see Mississippi State again. In 1978, they beat Florida State 55-27. This is the most points since for Mississippi State. Well, sir, what a way to go. If you're going to get into a bowl game, go in first class. Wang goes back, but it is taken instead by the up man, who is Gajon, a fullback, and he gets out to the 20-yard line. And that is all.
Bringing this team back.
Richard throws, it may be intercepted. It is not intended for McDaniel.
And have come on very strong.
Richard, second down from the 20-yard line. Richard rolling out. Now he's going to run, and he's close to the first down, but that takes time off the clock, and Curtis Stowers, a junior middle.
His passes, he's got two more years in Tigerland. He'll give them something to be proud of.
Third down and two. Risher hands the ball off for a couple of yards, and it is a first down. I was about to say, Bud, as a quitting team at all, they've hung in there, and they do, as you say, have a bunch of young folks, and they're not too far away from being an outstanding team themselves. Risher back on first down. Risher throws, and whoops! Wallace can't hold on to the football. Ducking low for it at the 40.
Continued to play absolutely first-rate football.
Second down, 10 from a 31-yard line of LSU. Risher in deep trouble. Tries to get out of it. Kenoff scissored down with Billy Jackson leading the way, along with Ernie Barr. The Bulldogs have already scored 31 points in the second half. Oh, my, trying to stand up and pass block is Dave Cook, a sophomore to Houston, and that's going to cost them five more yards.
They also got a chance to listen a little bit to the Notre Dame-Alabama game, which they're interested in.
Risher, long pass, maybe intercepted, but it's incomplete. Intended for Lance. And so now David Johnston has to kick the ball away. Johnston kicks it away. Line by McDowell, and McDowell cannot get out of the grasp of a fine tackle there made by number 19 of LSU, Alex Clark, a sophomore from Mississippi State. The last three kicks we've had, there's been a clipping penalty called it. Remember, he was a wishbone quarterback in school. Knows how to run it. Doss is your tight end on this side. Harrington keeps the football, turns it upfield. Wow! Did he run into...
Haven't played much in the varsity college football game. The tempo's a little different. Harrington makes a very good decision here as he rode the fullback, turned upfield, but watch Richardson nail him. That's perfect form tackle. Had his weight low, was able to lift the ball carrier off the ground and drive him back.
Second down and six for Mississippi State. Full house back to you. Harrington this time hands off to Edwards, the fullback, who gets across here. And you can see that LSU has controlled this series, but they're not controlling this game. Third down and short. Harrington loses the football, and LSU has jumped on it.
We've had, as we watch the play again, I don't know really what quite happened. He didn't get the ball in here. He didn't pull the ball out. It was absolutely loose. Just poor handling on the exchange and the recovery made by Louisiana State. The first turnover by Mississippi State.
Tracy Porter goes wide to the right. And that play's not going to go too far because of Billy Jackson, number 91. Porter and Wallace both go to the right for LSU. And now we have Mahfouz in there as the quarterback. Wallace knocked down in the end zone by Greg Williams, back a junior out of Lafayette.
He made a very good throw here, short drop, and then he dropped back deeper, delivered the ball, and at reasonably good pass protection. Looked like Wallace had a chance to get it, but it was broken up at the last minute.
It is third down. Mahfouz goes back. Mahfouz passes the ball out. That is Hernandez, who gets knocked to the first down. It'll be fourth down and 4 or 5 to go. Clay Peacher, he had to be thrilled at the end of the first half at 24 all, and now it's 55-24 Mississippi State. Fourth down, they gotta go for it. Down by 31. No cost of the wins. Ball is thrown out, and that is Mike Monts. He's got the first down. First down inside the 15-yard line. Mike Monts, so move
for the first down.
The two fine quarterbacks, Alan Risher of LSU and John Bond of Mississippi State, are through for the day after putting on an outstanding exhibition. Mahfouz spins around, hands the ball off to the first man through, who gets down to the 15-yard line, and that is
Arm.
It is second down. They can get a first down without having to get the touchdown. Mahfouz hands the ball off. Ten-yard run for Gene Lang, and another touchdown in this ball game, and another touchdown for Lang. That's his second.
It's a quick handoff. Lang has got that breakaway speed. He was supposed to hit it inside. He found a little crack, then moved almost laterally and used his speed to outrun the defensive secondary of Mississippi State to go into the end zone standing up.
David Johnstall. No mistake when I say the score is 55-31. And yes, yes, I know that Colorado hit, and when Oklahoma ran wild and they set a record. But when you've got 86 points in a single ball game, that's a lot of points. As they send on, of course, James Wagner, the freshman, to do the kicking. Nope. Kick the ball away. Wansley watches it go out of bounds, and so they'll have to kick it again from the third ball. Outstanding show, SportsCenter on ESPN. Wagner to kick it off again, 6:53 to go. Mississippi State with a controlled drive here could just end the ball game. Last time, they did not try onside kick, and I doubt that they will here either, and will not. Taken by the up man, who is Wansley. Wansley going toward the center of the field. He's got great speed and runs into a fine tackle of LSU by Norman Hector.
That's enough yardage normally if your defense holds up to give you control of a football game. And with Reischer being a sophomore and most of the team young, they've got a bright future to look forward to.
Eating up the clock, Bond along the sidelines. Carry was made by Windham.